Wyn Thomas's Drive Time, now playing worldwide.
On 106.5 FM and online, it's the After 5 Guest with Wyn Thomas.
And time now for the After 5 Guest today. And this year sees the 50th anniversary of the New Seekers. And commemorate that is a release of the 3-CD set called Gold, released on the 25th of September, which includes 8 top 20 hits and 2 number ones. And with me from the New Seekers is Marty Kristian. Thank you very much for joining us today, Marty.
Hi there, Wyn. Good to be with you.
Can I say that the New Seekers was a kind of an early X Factor band? It was sort of put together. Would I be right in saying that?
Yeah, you would be right, actually. The way it all happened was that when the Seekers split up, the original Seekers, their founder member, a guy called Keith Potka, decided that he wasn't ready to sort of hang up his guitar or close his bank account, as it were. And he got together with another fellow Australian called David Joseph, and together they thought of forming another band in a similar sort of vein to sort of fill the void that had been created. And it was a harmony band that he was looking for. So, you would be right in saying that.
So were you sort of recruited from music papers or things like that? How did you get into it?
No. I'd been a solo singer in Australia, and I worked my passage over as an entertainer on one of the ships, and was in England, and I had a call from David Joseph, whom I performed for in Australia on one of his TV shows called The Go Show. And somehow he tracked me down, and then he told me about the idea that he and Keith had for the forming of the new band. And David is a very persuasive guy and talked me into joining the group.
So you didn't know any of these guys in the New Seekers before you actually met them then, did you?
No, I didn't know any of the original lineup. But then after about 9 months, the group, not having had any hit records at that time, was about to sort of blow up. And I was going to leave and everything else. There were a few contractual problems and ego problems and stuff. And then David talked me into staying because he said an old friend of mine from Australia was going to join us, a guy called Peter Doyle.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Who had an amazing 3.5-octave voice. And that was the only reason I stayed, really.
Right, okay. And the kind of breakthrough song was I Like to Teach the World to Sing, was it, which was a Coca-Cola advert originally, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. The way that's started out was we did a bunch of radio jingles in America.
All right, yeah.
About 26, I think it was. And they were like 30-second jingles that they used to farm out to all the radio stations and then gauge the reactions in the various territories. And Teach the World to Sing was head and shoulders above everything else, so they decided to make it their flagship advert and do a TV commercial on it.
But it was a fantastic career, wasn't it? There were so many things to sort of I could talk to you about. Let's pick out a couple of them. 1973, at the inauguration of President Nixon, you were invited to sing. That was incredible, wasn't it?
Well, yeah. I mean, we weren't the only band, but purportedly it was Nixon's favourite tune. So when he was bombing Cambodia and flattening Vietnam, there he was twiddling his thumbs singing, "I'd Like to Teach the World to Sing."
I see your point, yeah. And, of course, the Eurovision Song Contest entry, Beg, Deal, or Borrow.
Yeah.
A great success, but only a runner-up.
Well, yeah. Funny enough, it was number 2 in the charts when we actually did the song contest. And, interestingly, we did the contest in Edinburgh. And at the Edinburgh airport, there was a huge banner outside reading, "Edinburgh welcomes the New Seekers." The only problem was that we arrived by train. But it was a fantastic time. And funny enough, we only lost by a few points. We were quietly confident that we had a good chance of winning in those days. Until it came to the voting, we were out in front until it was Ireland's turn and then Spain's turn to vote. Ireland gave us 3 points and Spain gave us 2, I think. So we lost by a few points to Vicky Leandros, sadly.
Oh, Vicky Leandros, that was the year she actually won it, was it? All right,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Okay. So what happened in the end then? Do you sort of want to go your own separate ways of the Seekers? The new Seekers?
What do you mean after we split up?
Yeah. Did you sort of want to all go your own ways after, in the end, or you had enough being together? What happened there?
We had huge success up till 1974.
Yeah.
We had all the hit records. We travelled the world. We lived in America for a time. Met all sorts of interesting people. Sold 36 million records in total. And, yeah. But like everything else, everything comes to an end. What happened was Eve had featured on many of the hit records, and then when Lynn had her hit record with You Won't Find Another Fool Like Me, the boat started to rock a bit and egos got in the way, and eventually we split up.
So do you see any of them and the members now?
I regularly see Paul and play golf with him from time to time. Peter Doyle sadly passed away.
Oh, yes.
He was a great mate of mine from Australia.
Yeah, yeah.
So that was a real sad loss for all of us. But I haven't seen the girls for a long time.
So you're kind of coming back now, aren't you? We just played Time In just before the news, which is your new single from the new album, which is coming out soon, isn't it?
Well, it is coming out soon. It'll probably be the first of next month, so I'm quite pleased about that. It's a country-oriented album, as you probably detected from the timing song. Yeah.
And we also, right at the start, sort of towards the beginning of Drive today, we did play your number one hit from the charts, from the country charts, which was Bring the Curtain Down with Arlene,
with
isn't
Arlene,
it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting story on that one too, because funnily enough, I've never actually met Arlene. We've had numerous chats on the phone, and we've texted each other and emailed, etc. What happened was I sent, I'm a songwriter, so I've sent loads of songs out to different people, and I sent one of these out to a guy called Lee Williams, who's got a radio station in Nashville. And
right.
One of his proteges was Arlene, and he played it to her, and she loved it. She actually flew to Nashville to record it, and she recorded it with top musicians, people that recorded it with Dolly Parton and Reba McEntire and people like that, all the big country stars. Anyway, when I heard it, when she played it to me, I thought it was amazing. But I felt it it sort of lacked a little ingredient. And so I asked her if she'd mind if I put a harmony on it. And
mm-hmm.
she said, no, go for it. So I recorded a harmony in my studio. She loved it. She sent it back to her producer in Nashville, who put it on the record. And then she asked me to join her on the record. So, yeah, after 50 years of hits in 1970, we're back again with the number one country song,
yeah.
Which is fantastic.
So you've never actually... You still never met, have you?
We still haven't met, no, but we talk frequently, and I've written another couple of songs that we're going to record with her, so let's see how those do.
That's incredible, isn't it? So that's just sort of modern technology, isn't it, when you can actually sing in one country and somebody else sing in another country, couldn't you?
You can these days. Everything's possible, especially with lockdown as well. It was a strange time. So, because lots of things can be done remotely these days. And, you know, you write something, you send something out, and someone can put a vocal on it, so you can collaborate in that way.
Did an interview last Friday, actually, with a band who actually, two live in Spain, one lives in the Bahamas, one lives in New York, so they've never, they get together sometimes, but not always, all the time.
Right.
It's just incredible, yeah.
And then you've got different approaches and different experiences from different people, and I think it sometimes can work out great.
So what's the new album going to be called, Artie?
Who, my album?
Yeah.
It is actually called Timing.
Oh, it is Timing, yeah, okay. Yeah. Right, okay. That's the title track we played today then, was
yeah.
it? Yeah, yeah. So is this love of country come from somewhere, or has it always been something you've liked?
Well, I've written all kinds of genre. I mean, I was steeped in rock and roll as a kid, but what I like about country or country rock in this day and age is that it's very much of a crossover from rock to traditional music and, you know, from folk music to Cajun and all the rest of it. But what I do like about country is it usually has fabulous melodies and a great storyline, and I'm a bit of a storyteller myself.
Okay, yeah, yeah. So going back to the new Seekers, it's the 50th anniversary.
Yeah.
It's a 3D set, CD set, which has been released called Gold. It's an absolutely incredible number of songs on there, isn't it?
It is. It's more than just a compilation. I mean, the way I look at it, it's a complete anthology of all the new Seekers hits, the B-sides. It also includes tracks that were hits in other territories that people might not have heard and so on. So, yeah, it's an enthusiast sort of... bit of gold to dip into.
Yep, yep. I know one of our DJs here, when she heard you were on the program today, was absolutely, she had a crush on you from the early age. So she's she's really enjoying this interview, I suppose, yeah. Marty, thanks so much for being my After Five guest today. It's been absolutely brilliant to talk to you, a real honour. And good luck with the new album when it comes out.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure talking to
Thank
you.
Thank you. We're going to play some New Seekers, and this is the Pete Townsend song, which is from
People Wizard. Tell me, right?
Yep, yeah, we're going to play that. Here we go. Yes, the New Seekers and from Pinball Wizard and See Me, Feel Me. And thanks to Marty Kristian for being my After Five guest today. And as I say, that new album comes out, as I say, on the end of September. It's called Gold. And if you're a New Seekers fan, it's absolutely every track imaginable that the New Seekers actually sang. All the hits and all the, as Marty was saying, all the B-sides as well.